a main class, nothing more than that. Okay, now inside the main, inside the composition package, I'll create another package which is a laptop. Okay, inside this laptop you have a class, and that class is laptop. Okay, so what are all the components of all the properties of this laptop? You have a screen. Let me write it down. Okay, these are all the things. See, now there is an error on processor and there is an error on graphics card. Okay, so this processor is a different class, because again processor is having many components in it, and this graphic card is also having many components in it. So I'll simply create a package in the composition telling that laptop components. Okay, inside this laptop components, I'll create a class, and I'll name this class as processor first class, and another component which will be my graphic card, graphics card. Okay, so what are all the properties of a processor? Our components. Okay, one, what are all my graphic property? Have an idea what is a graphic card and what is a processor, it will be very good. Otherwise it is okay. If you know how a laptop works and what are all the components of the laptop, then that is enough. I am importing these two classes. My importing is done. Okay, so I have written two frequencies. One is for the current frequency on which our laptop is working, and the minimum frequency of the laptop and the maximum frequency of the laptop. Okay, and the graphics. So a brand, a series, a memory. So that is what it is. So I'll create an object for my laptop. When I say lap dot, do I find anything?
No.
No, we are not finding anything related to anything. So the reason why we are not having anything in the laptop is
because it is private.
One, it is a private. Two, there are no methods in it.
Yes, sir.
Because we are not having any getter methods, we are not able to find out anything over here. But what is the use of having any getter methods? If you have some data, then we can get it. Is there any data over here?
No, sir. No.
Obviously, we are not having any data over here. So there is no need of having any getter methods. So initially, what I'll do is I'll give some default data. Okay, as we have seen already, how do we put the default data?
Using constructors.
Exactly. So you can construct, you can generate a constructor, a default constructor, where I can put some default values. So my default value will be screen. So my screen is of 14 inches, so I'll put as 14. You can put whatever you want. And here, processor. So how do you give a processor value? Processor is a class, right?
Yes.
So if you want to give some value to a processor, how do you give it? Any idea?
No.
So can I say simply processor is equal to new processor?
Okay, we need to call up.
Okay, so now let's go back to our default values. Okay, what I'll do is I'll simply copy this, I'll paste it over here, and I'll simply change these values to 14. These are my properties of my laptop. Okay, any laptop, these are the only features. Understand this. Any laptop, these are the features. So again, I need to go back to my processor. I have to specify all the processor details. I have to specify all the graphic card details. Understand? Now, if I print my lappy, I'm printing the object of the lap. If you see here now, I'm getting a random address. The reason why I'm getting a random address is in this lap, I am not created a toString method. If I create a toString method, then I'll get all my default values. Okay. Now I'll run the same thing. Good. Now see here, I'm getting my screen 14 inch. When I come to processor, again, it is creating me an object. I'm not getting the details of my processor. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
As well as over here, I am getting an object. For all the other things, I am getting the details whatever I have given over here. Okay, But when I am talking about my graphic card or my processor, since they are a different classes and I have only created an object, I am accessing their objects. I am not accessing the details of them. So whenever a object is created, a constructor is called, right? You have a default constructor over here. First, let me generate a constructor where my constructor will have no elements in it. And then let me create another constructor where it will have all the elements, control A and OK. Okay. Now it is having all the elements and it is crying very badly because I have not used it and I have not given any default variables. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. And let me give some default variables. Configurations may vary, so not a problem. So this is my processor details. Okay. So now when I run this, boom, you can see over here. Okay, my processor is not giving me those values. Why? Can anyone tell me why?
There is no toString method.
Exactly. Because we have not returned a toString method. So I'll generate a toString method with all the variables. And now I'll run this. Now you can see my laptop is giving me my laptop details as well as it is giving me my processor details also. Got it? But when I come to my graphic card, it is giving me address. So again, I'll go to my graphic card. Now I'll run this. Now check it out. My laptop is returning me a processor. Again, a processor is giving me all its processor values. And again, my graphic card is giving me my graphic card values. Understand this?